You know, it took amazing sums of capital to build railways, so that the ability to attract a railway was no easy matter. Now, if we use a spatial statistic, we can carry on with our impressions and sort of check them. Here is a social or a spatial statistic and the results, which shows show us two different clusters of rail transport. The red clusters are those areas where there is an extraordinarily high concentration of rail service. The you see Montpellier at the bottom and Marseille. These are sort of the entrepôts for regional, but Mediterranean, but also world commerce that comes to France and is then shipped up the rail lines to Chalon-sur-Saône by Dijon up to Paris and other places. We see Bordeaux also being highly favored with rail transport, an entrepôt for great wines and so forth. But then we also see in Tours, the textile center of Evreux, Chalon-sur-Saône, I noticed, but then this big clutch of rail service, dense rail network in the north, the industrial heartland, and rich agriculture. Okay, so this is a picture, even a still picture of uneven development, regional disparities in rail transport.